we meet our first guest, let's watch a little film that was written by a little girl. She only has little thin hands and she used to touch herself on the face. I go, write a film then, you little cow.
Meatloaf got his name when the school bus he was travelling on smashed into a cafe. The last thing he saw were the words Meatloaf on a sign. When he came out of his coma, he'd mutter it over and over again, and it became his name. Many of the other survivors remain friends with Meatloaf to this day, and he regularly goes bowling with Caesar salad, soup of the day, and staff needed apply within. Welcome to One Leicester Square, Meatloaf!
I was standing outside the door, right?
Yeah.
And I just was standing there thinking, well, how cool would it have been if when they go meet off, absolutely nothing happens.
You're right. What? And then you come in and there's silence.
And complete silence.
Let's try it.
Okay. And you, right. We go ahead and we say
complete hello. Silence. Complete silence. So Meatloaf comes in. Eerie silence. Right, Meatloaf, I'm going to do it. I'm going to announce you as if something eerie is going to happen.
Okay, great. You got it. Go.
All right. Just put them there. Do it all nicely. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on Leicester Square, Meatloaf.
And now there's a guy out here asking, what the hell is going on?
We're confused.
There's a guy out here going, what the hell's going on? We're trying another entrance, okay?
We
didn't like that one. You got a problem with it, buddy?
Fuck him up, Meat.
Yeah, I think I will.
Meatloaf again.
It's like we had a good thing going to go on, right?
Yeah.
We had a good thing about to happen, and some guy goes out there, what the hell's going on now?
Some pain
we
pusher.
We were doing art, man.
Ah.
It was, how do you say that?
Ah!
Ah!
They're making
art!
Ah!
Yeah, that's what it was, art.
I think artists throughout history, Meat, have faced this kind of constant oppression from pen pushers and boffins and squares.
No, that guy was definitely not a pen pusher.
He wasn't pushing a pen?
No, he definitely wasn't.
What do you think he pushes? Poop through letterboxes.
I think it... What?
Poop through letterboxes. Like maybe he opens a letterbox.
What the hell are you talking about?
Just human life, Meat. Human
no,
life.
No, I got that part. I understand
alive.
Human life, but what does he do?
Push poop, excrement, through a letterbox.
Oh, poop through a letterbox.
Do you have letterboxes in America?
Yeah, but we don't have poop.
Well, for God's sake, no wonder everyone's so frustrated.
That's right.
No wonder all these unnecessary wars are starting. People need a good shit.
That's exactly right.
You are here, Meat.
I am?
It's a, yes, definitely.
Okay.
There's no doubt
about
that.
Are you here?
In this life, I am currently here in my present form.
Okay.
You are here to promote a new record, Bad Bell Free.
Well, we don't got to.
All right. Well, no, it's better to. It's good because it's like, you know, ultimately...
I mean, we can talk about anything you want.
We will.
You know?
We will.
Okay, fine.
But there is a machine. Behind this moment, there's a machine working. MTV has got a machine behind it. You are part of a record industry, music industry. We have to do certain things. But we are not free, are we, ultimately?
Yes, we are. We
are
don't
we?
Need to talk about it.
We're ultimately free.
No, let me see the card. What does the card say?
Right, let me just make sure
read the card. Read the card. Let me just look at the...
album, Bad of Hell 3.
Okay,
two previous
just, let me
Bad
just
of
see.
Hell albums.
Okay, a new album. Okay, promote Meatloaf. Just so everybody knows, you
two
can see
words.
These cards. Meatloaf, two words, correct, very good. Promoting, new album. Do you have cards for this for everybody?
No one else is doing Bad of Hell 3. Only you.
And that, okay, so no one else is doing this, but promoting, you do put promoting up
promoting,
there.
It's got to be promoted.
Right. It's promote, yeah, okay, promoting Bad Outta Hell 3. The two previous Bad Outta Hell albums have sold nearly 50 million copies worldwide.
Whoa!
Okay, now, Russel, let's go to the clip.
Do you think now's the right time for the clip?
I mean, think it's perfect.
Do you think we're ready for a clip?
Yeah! thought for a second that the clip was not going to show me at all, just my feet.
Yeah, that'd be ridiculous.
Well, it almost didn't, see, because you can't really tell what that video is, but that video is really good, and everybody should watch it, because it is spectacular. Not because I'm in it, not because of the song, not because of anything, other than the director, Paul Brown, did an unbelievable
job.
Did
he? It looked like a Venetian masked bull, that video.
Well, it's actually, what's the Cruise Kidman movie?
Eyes Wide Shut.
Eyes Wide Shut. Yeah, I took it from Eyes Wide Shut.
Did you?
And Aida. That's the concept for behind it.
Eyes Wide Shut, I mean, I don't know if our viewers will know, there was a lot of muck went on in that film. A lot of our
A lot of really tall, statuesque women with no clothes on.
Exactly.
Yeah,
mucky
which
business.
Which you would have really liked, didn't you?
I would have enjoyed that.
Yeah,
meet,
I thought so.
But I'm trying to move on.
I heard
from
that
my...
about you.
Have you heard
yeah.
that?
Yeah. You wouldn't believe the rumors I've heard about you, man.
Well, let me assure you.
Are they true?
Most of them.
Okay.
Meatloaf, you once got in a sticky situation trying to get into Germany because they wouldn't let you through because there was complications about passport. Is
well,
that
they
true?
Had meatloaf on passport.
What's the problem with that?
Well, I don't know. But I also got taken to jail because my driver's license said meatloaf. But when I went into the police station and the guy behind the desk at this annex as I'm walking, he goes, "Meatloaf, what are you here for?" And the guy carrying my driver's license, he drove me to the gas station and put gas in my car.
Really? As a way of an apology?
Yeah.
he put it in the petrol tank, didn't he? Not on the seats
yes,
or something?
Yes, no, he did. He put it in the petrol tank. That was a good place to put it, I thought.
Perfect place for it.
Yeah.
Unless he was an arsonist or something, in which case, spray it willy-nilly.
Well, I'm not really sure I like the way your eyes looked when you said arsonist or something.
Oh, so what, did they light up?
Yeah, they
As if
did,
I might be a bit of a pyromaniac.
Just a smidgen.
I am excited by fire meat.
You are?
I'll be... not fire meat. That sounds weird. But fire, new sentence, meat.
Meat, yeah. I got it. It was a period at the end of fire.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
there was a period. And not that, you know. So, like... But I'll tell you for why, because I suppose it's elemental, isn't it? Like, if you think of fire stolen by Prometheus from the gods, given to man the first time man struck out, all independent, as long as we have power over fire meat, we can do anything.
You can damn well sure cook a weenie.
I think mine's cooking just from this chin wag. My weenie's piping hot it is.
Okay, just
meat.
Moving over here. Yeah, well, you know...
It's getting cooler.
No, baby, I don't play with that team.
Just give it a try.
No, that's okay. I did in the Rocky Horror Picture Show, remember?
Yeah, I remember.
Well, no, not that, but in the show, I wore... fishnet stockings and high heels and what you don't refer to them as garter belts here, you call them suspenders in England.
Did you ever put them sort of that gear on at home? You know, dress up, get all sexy.
Are you fucking out of your mind?
Sometimes. Meat, you've got two teddy bears called Marietta and Mandy who bring you good luck when you tour the world.
And they talk.
They talk, these
yes,
bears.
Yes, they do.
Say them teddy bears, mate, started giving you advice that seemed inappropriate and cold.
Like what?
Like, say they go...
Give me an example.
All right. Say that I'll be the teddy bear.
Okay, you be... I figured you might be.
Why not?
Okay, I figured you'd go that way.
Right. Meatloaf, after your concert, why don't you steal some wheelchairs, get yourself in one of the wheelchairs, go around a hospital and touch nurses? If it said that, would you consider doing it?
Well, you didn't have the right voice.
How do they talk?
Well, they don't talk like that.
Go on, then.
They sound like bears.
Meatloaf.
No. Okay, it's in between that and the other one.
Meatloaf!
There you go. You got it. It's sort of parrot-like. Yeah, that's right.
I might take me and my bear. We go out on Sundays, and we go to the hospital, and we get in wheelchairs, and we roll through the wheelchairs, and we go around, and we touch bums of nurses.
Lovely meatloaf bear. Welcome. You'd be a good pirate.
You think?
Definitely.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think you could be a good pirate.
Yeah,
Meat, will you please stay with us and answer questions from people in the audience? There's a lot of people here who have got very, very deep psychological problems, and I think only you can help them.
I'm sure that I can help them.
I think you can.
I can help them.
Ladies and gentlemen, please round of applause for Meat Loaf. We're going to have a quick commercial break now, for God's sake. Have a look at some of these products. They could make you happier inside. We'll be back in a little while. For half an hour, I want to squaw.
Still to come, him, her, and a performance from them.
Meet, think this is the best part of the show. It's called For Pity's Sake Help Us. What we do is we get people here that some of them have got problems, you'll have noticed.
I noticed.
Well,
we saw that earlier.
It was apparent. So as long as you two are ready to help, are you lot ready to be helped?
Yeah!
In which case, let us get on with another round of For Pity's Sake Help Us. Hello, dear.
Hello.
What seems to be the trouble? What's your name called? Heidi.
Heidi.
Heidi,
yeah.
Is an actual person. We've captured one. Heidi, what seems to be the trouble? Ask me and Jodie. They will assist you.
Okay. My boyfriend slept with my best friend.
Bastard!
I don't talk to either of them now, but should I? Everyone always says how you're meant to save the friendship. Should I let it all go and make friends with her, or should I?
Well, if I can speak for that, because I've
which
had exactly the same thing happen to me, and I don't speak to either of them, and I don't think you should ever speak to them again. And what,
were they drinking when this happened?
Yeah, they always are, aren't they?
They were drinking.
Are they still doing it? No, they're not.
And
no.
Was it just one time?
Twice, I think.
Twice.
Were
in
you
the
watching?
Same night, or was it twice in the same night, or did it occur on two different days?
Two separate occasions.
They didn't
did
learn.
From wait, let me finish this.
This advice better save her fucking marriage.
Wait, just a second.
All right, I'm listening.
Okay.
I'm waiting for the advice.
I'm trying to find out all the information.
All right.
You can't give good advice if you don't have all the information.
All right, I'll get the information.
That's what I'm trying to do, but you're interrupting.
You've caused this rift between me and you.
You're kidding. You know what? You never should speak to either one of them again.
Thank you.
Yes.
Good advice for me, though.
Are you happy? I don't need to just be taken along on a tidal wave of adrenaline and testosterone.
I'm fine. I no longer need therapy.
I think meatloaf's
worse. What if they wanted you to join them?
Oh, hello.
I've been there and done that.
Wait. Hang on.
This is about advice.
I don't care how many times you've been there and done that. There's always room for more.
Meatloaf, if you're trying to get Josie and Heidi in some sort of three-way fuckfest, I will film it.
I agree.
For Pete's sake, we've helped her. It's going to be a lovely video. Hello, dear.
Hello.
What seems to be the trouble?
I've got a really annoying mate at work. Meatloaf, maybe you could help with this one.
Slap him.
He's annoying, he is.
You've got an annoying mate at work. What's your name?
Shanine.
Shanine's got an annoying mate at work. What does this annoying mate
what
do?
What he does is when he's got itchy bits,
He's got
a habit of...
Do you mean his genitals?
Right. He's got a habit of shaking his leg out like a dog.
Hold on. Show me.
Do I have to?
Yeah. He gets itchy bits.
He does.
And then what happens?
Like that. And
he shakes really, his leg like that.
Yeah, he just does it randomly and it's really annoying.
Well, it's not random, it's happening when his bits itch.
Yeah.
It's
really
well, how do you know that he's shaking his leg because his bits itch?
No, I know. The look in his eyes, I know.
You know, hold on. Meatloaf, if your bits itch,
what
do you ever
do?
Go like that?
No, I just usually put my hand down my pants.
Because when my bits itch, I sort of do a little shimmy like that.
Oh, Russell.
So would that affect our friendship?
Yeah.
I'm doing it now.
No.
Oh, Christ.
I have another suggestion. Take some anti-itch talcum powder into work with you and just give it to him every time he shakes his leg.
Thrush cream.
Oh. Yeah. Oh.
Jodie, you think he's got thrush?
Probably, if he's itching that much.
Jodie, is that the voice of experience?
You're a dirtbag, no.
Seems I'm just as I'm saying. Not the dirtbag. Mine are in great shape.
Okay, so what's Ziggy's surname? I'll give him a message straight down the barrel.
Ziggy!
Ziggy! Get your fucking hands out of your trousers. No, actually, stop going like that and moving your leg. Get your hands down your trousers like meatloaf and have a scratch of your balls, but for God's sake, rinse your hands afterwards, you disgusting pervert. For Pete's sake, we've heard that. Your name is Dan, you've got a problem. What the fuck are we gonna do? What's the problem, Dan?
Well, Russell, I slept with the same two girls on the same day.
You sick, sick bastard.
And one of the girls told my mum, and now my mum's...
Jealous, is she?
And now my mum is making me go to sex therapy.
Your mum is making... That can't help. Why are you at this sex therapy? Because of my mother.
Are you friends with Heidi?
No, no.
One of them's here.
Cheers.
Oh, hello. Right, which one are you? Number one or number two?
I think I was number one.
Good girl.
Did you tell Mom?
No.
Right, so the other girl said, I had it off with Dan on the same day as, what's your name?
Natalie,
the human female, fucking Dan, with his ragged cock, all empty. Right, okay, Natalie, I don't blame you. It's only a little bit of fun, ain't it? Now, but Dan is the one with a problem. He's our sex therapist at the recommendation of his mother. What are we gonna do with Dan? He's already been to a sex therapist. The best sex therapist in England has decided he can't help Dan. Meet, what do you suggest?
What's your name again?
Natalie.
Natalie, and what was the other girl's name?
Natalie and Michelle.
I think you get Natalie, Michelle, and Heidi and go for it, baby.
Go for it, Dan. That sounds like a solution. Jody?
I would say, you know, if you're going to sex therapy, then get as much out of it as you can and just, you know, pick their brains, use it to your advantage. I'd love to go to sex therapy.
Would you?
Yeah.
You should probably pop along before you get another dose of thrush. For Pete's sake, we've helped him. Across this landscape of recently helped
but
people.
Can I just ask her why she wants to go to sex therapy?
Jodie, why?
I'm not getting any. I don't want to know why.
Sex therapy's going to help you get some?
I don't know. I've obviously got problems.
He's really good.
He's probably done it twice today, poor sod. He's probably exhausted. Ladies and gentlemen, Meatloaf and Jodie Martin!